Hi friends, it's our second week of a resiliency workshop today, and there couldn't be a better time for it. The sun is shining and I think it's gonna be a great day. I hope that something wonderful happens in your day today too. Our topics this week are emotions and stress, so hard things in our day, right? We have hard things no matter what our age is. Today, we are gonna read this book called When You Are Brave at the end of our time together. And it just talks about how we all have an inner light or an inner strength that we can call upon when times get tough, okay? So to begin with, once you sit crisscross applesauce or lie down on your floor or mat, you just want to have a nice long line from the top of your head to your tailbone. So give your lungs lots of room to expand and contract, okay? All right. So today, again, we're going to do our finger counting breath, because once you're not learning something new, it becomes a better tool to just use automatically when you're feeling stress. All right, I'll hold my hand up so you can see it, but you can have your hand in your lap or on your tummy or wherever. All right, so you can rest your eyes closed or keep them open, it's up to you. Bring your thumb to the base of your pointer finger, and here we go. Trace up your pointer finger, inhale, trace down, exhale. Trace up your tall finger, inhale, trace down, exhale. Ring finger, trace up. Inhale, trace down, exhale. Pinky finger, trace up, inhale, trace down, exhale. Ring finger, trace up, inhale, trace down, exhale. Tall finger, trace up, inhale, trace down, exhale. Pointer finger, trace up, inhale, trace down, exhale. Good, friends. I feel more relaxed already after a busy morning. Okay, friends. For our poses today, we are gonna do the poses that I usually use with the older kids at school. So younger kids, you pick what works for your body, okay? I think you're up for it and I think you can do it. I'll explain it well. And we'll just do what we can do and see how it works. We are going to do the same sequence next week. So this week will be like a learning time with the poses, and next week will become maybe more fluid for everyone, okay? So let's go ahead and start in our child's pose. So sitting on your feet, you can have your knees together or wide. I prefer mine wide. Walk your elbows to the mat. Drop your head to the mat or stack your fists and rest your head on there, your forehead. Take a little moment and see if you notice your lungs expanding and contracting against the tops of your legs. I always say this, but when I feel that feeling, I always imagine the ocean, how the ocean waves come in and contract, and come in and go back. It's just how our breath feels. If you don't feel anything against your legs, maybe try to take a deeper breath, deeper breath. On your next inhale, come up into tabletop. I'm going to turn sideways. You can stay facing me. I'm just gonna show you how this goes today, since some of these are new, okay? So we start in tabletop, and then we're going to go to cow. We drop our bellies, raise our hips and our head, cow. Exhaling into cat, like a Halloween cat, we arch our back. Then we just kind of flow with that. Inhale, cow. Exhale, cat. Inhale, cow. Exhale, cat. Inhale, cow. Exhale, cat. Very good, friends. Now from here, walk your hands one little step ahead. Tuck your toes under and raise your hips to the sky for your down dog, your first down dog. Your legs may feel a little tight, so you can bend one knee and then the other to kind of loosen up your legs. And then find some stillness. Find some stillness here. Next, we'll be doing two of these push-up sequences. The first, I'll have my knees down, and the second, I'll have my knees up. You can choose to do it either way, okay? So shift forward into your high plank. For this time, I'm dropping my knees, okay? I'm gonna lower all the way down to the floor and then push up into cobra. A lot of the kids do this because the cobras make a snake sound. Push back into your child pose just for a moment. Hands staying out front. Tuck your toes and come back into your downward dog. Good. Now you can do that exact thing once more, or you can do it with more strength building with keeping your knees up. You shift forward into a high plank, lower down halfway, push up into your up dog, and then push back into your downward dog. Very good. Take a big breath here. And on your exhale, step your feet between your hands. Inhale your arms up overhead and exhale to heart center. Okay, very good. Now, friends, we're going to start our standing part of the sequence for today, okay? So step back one leg into a warrior one. This is the pose we did last week. Inhale your arms up high. You want them straight and strong. Even though you're not supporting anything in your hands, you want your muscles to be engaged. Your front knee is bent. The lower, more you bend your knee, the harder that leg is working. Okay? So warrior one. Then arms back to airplane arms. Shift forward onto your front leg. Tip forward into your airplane. Very good. Back to warrior one. Now I'll add something new. I'm gonna wrap your arms behind your back. You can either grab opposite hands, your hands together, or you can reach for your elbows. Okay, either way works. When you're ready, fold forward over your front leg and let your head drop. In this pose, sometimes I like to let go of things that might be bothering me or stress that I'm having for that day. So let it roll off my back. Okay, inhaling up, back to warrior one. Very good. Okay, let's come to standing in mountain. Friends, now we're gonna do some challenging balance poses. And this is kind of stress, right? It's not a bad stress, but it adds stress to our life to do something hard. So let's see how that feels in our body, okay? Our prep pose is into chair. So remember, you bring your hips back like you're gonna sit in a chair. Then you look down and make sure you can see your toes. If you can't see your toes, you bring your hips even further back. Okay, from there, we're gonna bring our arms wide like a football goal post, okay? Bring one arm under, wrap your hands together, and seal it up with your hands like this. Whichever arm you have under, that's the leg you have over. So I have right arm under, right leg over. Okay. Good job, guys. It takes a while to figure this one out. I wish I was there with you to help you out. From here, let's unwind. we're gonna go to tree, okay? Remember, you can have your tree kickstanded like this with one foot on the ground. You can have your foot up on your calf, up on your thigh, just not on your knee, okay? So find the position you'd like to put your foot in. Find something to look at that's not moving to help with your balance. And once you feel steady, raise your hands to the sky and grow your tree branches. And back. Very good, guys. All right, step your other leg back. For me, I'm stepping my left foot back, but it's whichever one you didn't use last time. Okay, arms straight and strong. Very good. Knee bent, how far you'd like it. Arms back into airplane. Shift forward onto your front foot. Once again, look at something that's not moving. And tick-tock forward. Airplane crashed. Guys, sometimes that happens. Balance is hard for me. But everyone has things we're working on, don't we? Okay, back into warrior one. Arms straight and strong. Very good, guys. Grab your arms behind your back. Grab your hands or your elbows. Shift down forward over your front knee once more. And let your head drop. If you have thoughts coming into your mind while you're standing in silence, see if you can let those worries or things you might have to do roll away. And just think about where you are right now. Shift up to warrior one and step together for mountain. Very good. Now to our balance poses. Back to chair. Check in with your toes. Make sure you can see them. Arms out front. Very good. Arms up. Goal post. Wrap your opposite elbow underneath. Link your hands. Okay? This time I have my left elbow under and my left leg will go over. Now you'll notice that I have my raised toes kickstanded on the ground. Balance is my challenge point, so I choose to do it like this. You can also choose to raise or wrap your raised foot behind your calf if that's available to you. Okay, good. Friends, let's come out to mountain just for a touch. Then raise the foot that you had up before. For me, it's my left, into my tree pose. You choose which tree you'd like. Look at something that's not moving and grow your tree when you feel steady. Good. Okay, friends, back to the mat. We are going to do a little ab work with our boat pose today. Okay? So we are going to sit on our sit bones, feet down, knees up. Okay? Remember, this can be your boat. Just slightly leaning back. Your boat can look like this. I can feel my belly already working. To increase the challenge, I can lift my feet, arms straight forward. I can also lift my arms, that increases the challenge, and I can lift my legs, okay? Today, I choose to go here. Whatever works your belly the right amount for you today, that's your best choice, okay? I'm gonna count back from 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, you got this, 4, 3, 2, 1. Very good, friends. Okay, let's come to lie down on our mat. Okay, bring one knee, what's under my, oh my glasses, for Pete's sake. Okay, bring, okay, I got distracted by all the things under my head. Bring your legs long, and then bring your right knee in towards your body. You can grab behind your thigh, your shin, or take your peace fingers, wrap them around your big toe, and extend your legs long, or your one leg long. Now, if you are a dancer or very flexible, this is the pose for you. If you are not, this will hurt your body, okay? So stay here if that feels good for you. If it doesn't, stay with a pose like this. Okay, again, we're just trying to do what's best for each person's body. Okay, bring that leg back long. Bring your left knee in towards your body. Same options. Behind your thigh, your shin, or peace fingers around your big toe, and extend your leg out long. So nice to have such a sunny day today. All right, bring that leg back long. Rest your hands on your belly for just a minute. Bring your knees up toward the sky. Take a big breath in here and out. Good. Bring your hands wide. Let your knees fall to the left and your nose will point to the right. Okay, knees to the sky. Let them fall the other direction or to the right, and now your nose will go to the left. Arms still wide. Okay, friends, knees to the sky, hands wrapped behind. Roll on up. Okay, very good. To finish our practice today, guys, let's do a volcano breath, okay? I don't know if you remember from last week, but a volcano breath is our opportunity to send some good wishes or love to somebody that we know needs it today, okay? So bring someone into your heart. I have someone in mind. Okay. We inhale, bring our hands to the sky, imagine our person, and on the exhale, we blow our wish. Okay, friends, today, like I mentioned, we're gonna read this book called When You Are Brave. I love this book, okay? When You Are Brave. Some days, when everything around you seems scary, you have to be brave. Brave is a bird that steps from its nest, hoping to soar through the sky. Brave is a dog that wanders for miles, searching for one well-known light. Can you tell what's happening, friends? They're loading up their car to move. In grown-up language or adult figure kid language, we call that stress. But little kids' language, we can call it all sorts of other things like fear or anger or frustration, all the same kind of thing. Brave is a caterpillar that builds a bed, wondering when it will wake. Because some days are full of things you would rather not do. Like plunging into a pool all by yourself, hoping you will swim and not sink. Or standing alone in front of a crowd, searching for one friendly face. Or boarding the bus and riding to school, wondering what lies ahead. At times like these, the world can seem too big, too loud, too hard, or too much. Look at everyone's face. The baby's crying with his dad. This guy looks unhappy, looking for a cab.
Rush, 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 huh? While you feel too small, excuse me, too small, too quiet, too tired, or not enough. Look at their little car. They're surrounded by this big city. On those days, look deep inside to find the courage you need. It might be hidden away, but if you close your eyes and breathe, you will see it, shining its light in the dark, warm, steady, and safe. Your light might be small to start, just a spark, but you can turn it into a flame. Picture it in your mind, then imagine it becoming bigger and bolder. It's shining throughout the forest. You can make your courage so big, it brightens your heart, fills your fingers, and flows to your toes. Think about what you're good at, something you love, or someone who loves you. No one else will see it, but you will know that you glow, and you'll know you are ready. No matter how deep the water, how loud the crowd, how hard the ride, or how much there is to do, you might struggle, you might succeed. People might clap or laugh or not even notice at all. But no matter what happens, you will be all right. Because once you find courage, it's easy to use again and again. The next time life seems scary or you start something new, you can remember when you were brave. And then you can stand straight and walk tall, knowing you are as brave as a bird, a dog, and a caterpillar. As brave as you. Okay, friends, I love this book so much. I'm gonna turn back to one page. It is my favorite. Look at this little spark of courage that she finds in her heart. And then how it turns bigger and bigger. Friends, all of us have that spark of courage in our heart, right? So next time, if you're feeling scared or if you're feeling brave, perhaps you could put your hand to your heart and breathe in, put a little air to the flame, right, to make it grow. See if you can breathe into that courage and find yours, okay? All right, friends, it was nice to chat with you today and have our class together, and I'll see you next week. Bye.